Today we will discuss about statistics. So, dear students, what is statistics? Statistics is nothing beyond that the fact and figure. So, for the definition of statistics, statistics is the study of calculation, analysis, interpolation, presentation, and organization of data. Statistics is used everywhere. Wherever you can see, you will give, you will see an example of statistics. So, what are the main uses of statistics? For example, the first use is, it is a highly quantitative than qualitative. For example, from the social data to everywhere, you will give the statistics example, and from social data, this must be numerous in nature. So, for statistics, what is needed? Everywhere we need numerical or mathematical problem. So, second uses is fundamental regularity based on mathematical property. Wherever you go, the mathematics phenomena is used in statistics. Third is the appropriateness, clarity, measurability, and comparability. In statistics, what we will do? To compare two things, to measure anything, but every field we use the numeric part. The fourth one is statistical data must be manipulated, means in the tabulation, in divided, in division, and in calculation, finally we will get a result, that is the use of statistics. In calculation part, we will get a result for the conclusion. The fifth one is presentation of statistics data are given by the line diagram, graphs, charts, and histogram, etc. So, these are the five uses of statistics. Now, go for the limitations. What is limitation? We know statistics is a very wild area, but every person, everything has some limitations. So, it has also some limitations, and for example, a very important limitation is that statistics doesn't study qualitative phenomena. Means, if we are giving some intelligence, if we are giving some beautifulness, so there we cannot say about the quality. In statistical law are not exact. In case of natural science, there are many laws, but in the natural field, we are not able to use its originality. Third one is statistics doesn't hold for individuality, means always we need statistics for a group of individuals. For a single individual, it is not possible to find the data. What we will do if a single data is given for us? So, what we can do is it for a single data, we cannot do anything. So, for statistics, it is a very big problem. With a single data, we cannot do anything. So, it is a very big limitation for it. Statistics can be misused. Whenever we are giving, there are many problems, and in the main part is that if we have done some mistakes, the mistakes will be manipulated and we will not able to do anything. So, these are all the uses and this is the limitation. So, now go for what we will do about the next one. So, finally, if we are giving some data, so what we will do here? For data, for example, 5, 10, 15, 5, 10, 5, 20, 30, 5 and 10. Here we are given many more datas. So, here we have taken, if some number is repeated, then we will say this is frequency, and frequency is how often something occurs. In this example consists 5, 10, 15, 5, 10, 5, 20, 30, 5 and 10. So, here frequency of 5 is 4, because in this set 4 times 5 is used, 10 is 3 times used, 15, 30 and 20 are used only once. So, now measure of central tendency. What do we mean by measure of central tendency? Measure of central tendency is a single value that attempts to describe a set of data by identifying the central position with the set of the data. Means, if we are given with lots of data, measure of central tendency gives, it is a central position of this set of the set of data which gives or which is which the value attempts to describe a data with all this set of groups. Mean, median, mode are valid measure of central tendency. So, mean is the arithmetic mean, often called the average. Median is the positional average and mode is the highest frequency. So, first of all we should learn about mean. So, mean means for the individual observation, if we have n values in a set of data, they are called x1 to xn, then mean, which is written as x bar, is equal to x1 plus x2 to the xn divided by n, and this equal to summation of xi divided by n. So, for example, let us take 5, 6, 7, 8. So, mean of this 4 element is x bar equal to 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 8 by 4, that is equal to 26 by 4, which is equal to 6.5. For the discrete data, the formula for the mean is summation of fx by n, where f is the frequency, x are the variables and n is the number of observations. In this example, here marks are, these are the marks 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 and 70, and these are the students. 20 number of marks have acquired by 8 students, 30 marks is acquired by 12 students, and these are the frequency. So, for this, this is the fx. We have multiplied here this x, this is the x, and we have multiplied here this is f. So, f into x, fx are this 20 into 8 equal to 160, 30 into 12 is equal to 360, 40 into 20 800, and similarly we have calculated this and these are the fx. So, this is the summation of fx, this is addition of this total value, that is 2460, and this is the addition of this f, that is n equal to 60. So, according to our formula, x bar equal to fx by n, summation of fx by n, that is equal to, this equal to 41. And now using the shortcut method, here the formula is x bar equal to a plus summation of fd by n. A is the assumed mean, d is x minus a, and n is the total number of observation. So, here this is same example, last one is, so these are the values, these are x's, these are the frequencies, and this is here we have assumed 40 as assumed mean. So, now x minus 40 are this, x minus 20, 40, 20 minus 40 equal to minus 20, 30 minus 40 equal to minus 10 and so on. Similarly, we have calculated this, and now this is fd, this is f, this is d. We have calculated this 2 or multiplied this 2 and finally got the fd equal to 60. So, x bar equal to a plus fd by n, this equal to 40 plus 60 by 60. That is 40 plus 1 equal to 41. So, in the two example we get the same result. Now, for the continuous series, similarly, what is continuous series? If 0 to 10, 10 to 20, this is called the continuous series, and the direct method is x bar is equal to summation of fm by n, where m is the midpoint of the continuous series, f is the frequency, n is the total frequency. So, for the shortcut method, the formula is a plus fd by n, where d is m minus a, and if the formula changes, x bar is equal to a plus summation of fd by n into I, here d is m minus a by I. Now, let us take an example for the class interval. Here, from the following data, compute arithmetic mean, where the data are, these are the marks 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50 and 50 to 60. For this, the number of students, that is frequency, 0 to 10 is 5, similarly 10, 25, 30, 20 and 10 are respectively. So, for the direct method, these are the marks 0 to 10, 10 to 20, these are the marks, and the midpoint is written like this. 0 to 10, this is the 5 is the midpoint, for 10 to 20, 15 is the midpoint, similarly 25, 35, 45 and 55 are the midpoints. This is the given frequency and this is fm. So M into F, this is 5 into 5 equal to 25, then 10 into 15 equal to 150. Similarly, we have calculated this, and this is the summation of M, that is 3300, and N is equal to 100. So X bar is equal to, using our formula for the direct method, is 3300 by 100, that equal to 33. And now use the shortcut method. The first case one, here we have calculated the midpoint. We are given the number of frequencies or number of students, and here let's take 35 is the assumed mean. So D is equal to M minus A or M minus 35. So M is 5 and our 35 is A. So 5 minus 30 is, sorry, 5 minus 35 equal to minus 30, 15 minus 35 equal to minus 20, 25 minus 35 equal to minus 10, and so on. Now this is the F, this is D. So we have multiplied here FD. So F into 5 into minus 30 equal to 150, and similarly we have multiplied this two, and also on. So minus 150, minus 200, minus 250, and also all, and finding the total, that is summation of FD, that is minus 200, and here N is equal to 100. So using the formula for the shortcut method, case 1, X bar equal to A plus summation of FD by N, that is 35 plus minus 200 by 100, that is 35 minus 2, that is 33. Again, for the case 2, we have here marks is there, that is the X, midpoint is this, that is M, and these are the frequency. So here we have taken D is equal to M minus A divided by 10. Here the class interval is 10 and 35 is the assumed mean. So using this, these are the D, and FD equal to this all, summation of FD equal to minus 20, and here we have used the formula A plus summation of FD by N into I. So 35 minus 20 divided by 100 into 10 is equal to 33. So in all the three cases, we get mean equal to 33. So whatever you want to use in all the cases, whatever the formula is, our mean is always fixed, and we will get the answer in every method. Now for every thing, there is merit and demerit. So here for arithmetic mean, we also have some merits. So first of all, discuss about merit, then we will go for demerit. So first merit is, it is simplest average to understand and easiest to calculate. Second one is, it is defined by rigid mathematical formulae, and third one is, it is calculated value, not based on the position. There are also various types of uses. You can go through many different books and you may note yourself, and these are some demerits of this mean. First one is, it can neither determine by inspection or by graphical location. Means it is not possible to determine by inspection. If we are going to do inspection, we will not able to find the mean. By inspection, mean is not calculated. Second, it is too much affected by the extreme values. If we are giving the last values, last two values are called extreme values, and we are affected, here mean is affected by the extreme values. Third, it is not calculated when our class is open. So these are the three demerits, and there are three merits. So this all. Now comes for median and mode. What is median? Median is the positional average. So median is the positional average and mode is the maximum frequency value. For the discrete case, if n is odd, median is equal to size of n plus 1 by 2th item. And if n is even, median equal to n by 2th plus n by 2 plus 1th item by 2. So for example, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, here n is equal to 5, so median is the 5 plus 1 by 2, that is 6 by 2 is the third item. So median is 2, this is the third item, so this is 4. Now let's take another example. This is an example having n equal to 6, which is an even number. So median equal to 6 by 2 8 plus 6 by 2 plus 1 8 by 2 equal 3rd plus 4th position by 2, that is 4 plus 9 is equal to by 2 equal to 4.5. Let's take another example. Here some data given 2 3 4 4 5 5 6 7. So here mode is equal to 5. In this data, in this example, mode equal to 5. Again here 5 is repeated thrice. In this example, these are the two examples. Here 3 is repeated thrice and 4 is repeated thrice. So 3 and 4 both are called the mode. Similarly for continuous series, till now we have discussed about the discrete series. For the continuous series, the formula for mean and median and mode are L plus N by 2 minus CF by F into I, mode equal to this. Now let's take an example. So calculate median and mode for the following data, where marks equal to 45 to 50, 40 to 45, these are the marks, and number of students is this. So for the answer, first of all we have to arrange the marks in this order. From sorting we have lower to upper. So first 5 to 10, 7, 10 to 15, 15, 15 to 20, 24, and similarly we have arranged like this. Here this is CF. CF means cumulative frequency. This is cumulative frequency. How can we calculate cumulative frequency? This first F equal to 7, next 7 plus 15 equal to 22, next 24 plus 22 equal to 46, 31 plus 46 equal to 77, 77 plus 42 equal to 119, 119 plus 30 equal to 149, plus 26 equal to 175, 175 plus 15 equal to 190, plus 10 equal to 200. Similarly, we have calculated the CF. So here this is the last CF and this is the N. This must be equal, then only we can say our calculation is correct. So the formula for median is L plus N by 2 minus CF by F into I, where L, how we'll find the L? First of all, this is N by 2. N by 2 is 200 by 2, that is 100. So 100 lies in between 77 to 119. So this lies in the class interval 25 to 30. So let's mark this. This is the class interval, this is the median class. So L is the lowest element of this median class, that is 25. CF is the upper element of this median class, that is 77. F is the frequency of this median class, that is 42, and I is the class interval 25 to 30. So 30 minus 25 equal to 5. So here we have substituted the values. L equal to 25, N by 2 equal to 100, CF equal to 77, F equal to 42, and I equal to 5. So here we have calculated 25 plus this is equal to 27.74. Similarly for the mode, the formula is L plus F1 minus F0 by 2F1 minus F0 minus F2 into I. Here we are calculating mode. So for the mode, here 42 is the maximum value. So this is the modal class. The modal class is 25 to 30. So L is 25, lowest element of this modal class, that is 25. F1 is the frequency of this modal class, that is 42. F0 is the preceding element, preceding frequency, that is 31, and F2 equal to 30. So F1 equal to 42, F0 equal to 31, F2 equal to 30, and I equal to 5. So substituting all the values here, L and all these things, we have calculated the mode equal to 27.39. So please do yourself, make many more problems, and we will solve the problems. finally, there is a relation, mode is equal to 3 into median minus 2 into mean. This is the relation between mean, median and mode. So, you will do yourself, this modal value will be equal to 3 into this median values, and whenever you will find the mean, you can get the same values which is fine here. So, do yourself, many more practice. So, thank you. Thank you very much.